Hi, I'm Daniel. Let's talk accounting. You may need to pay additional JobKeeper payments to staff, but since this is a new scheme, there may be some setup before you process payroll. Today, I'll show you how to record JobKeeper payments in Xero. As always, check the description box for links. Please like this video if it helps you, and subscribe and hit the bell for updates and future videos. Xero tell us they have a new JobKeeper feature coming soon. In the meantime, they advise us to set up a new pay item in Xero Payroll to record the JobKeeper payments. Once Xero's new feature is available, they say they'll explain how to edit the pay item so it can be reported to the ATO with Single Touch Payroll. Before recording JobKeeper payments in Xero, you may wish to register your interest in applying for the JobKeeper payment via the ATO website. You may wish to set up Single Touch Payroll in Xero, and you may wish to review the eligibility criteria for the employer. Okay, let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is to create a new allowance pay item. Click on the company name, click on settings, click on payroll settings, click on pay items, click on add allowances, select Other, enter a name such as JobKeeper Payment Top-Up. Select Fixed Amount for Rate Type. The amount should be left at zero. And the expense account should be set to your wages and salaries account code. This item is not exempt from PAYG withholding. It may be exempt from superannuation guarantee contributions, and it is reportable on the activity statement as W1. Now that we've added the new pay item, we can see how this appears in a pay run. Click on Payroll, Pay Employees. Click Add New Pay Run. Select the relevant pay period. In this instance, we have three employees, James, Oliver, and Sally. James and Sally are already earning above the $1,500 per fortnight. There'll be no additional JobKeeper payments to make to them. However, Oliver only has $960. If we click onto Oliver's pay slip, we can add the additional payment. Click Add Earnings Line. Choose the JobKeeper payment top-up that we added earlier. Click OK. Here we need to add the difference between the $1,500 to be paid and the $960 already earned. We'll add the $540 to the employee's payslip under JobKeeper payment top-up. The employee earnings now show $1,500 for the fortnight. And the tax withholding has automatically recalculated now. Scrolling back up to the top, we see the employee's net pay of $1,282. And we may now click Save. And we would repeat this process for each other employee. Now, if it is likely that this payment will be made on a regular and ongoing basis, as seems likely, as much as perhaps 6 months, then it would make sense to add this to the employee's pay template. Let's look at how to do that now. Click on Payroll, click on Employees, click on the employees who are likely to need this additional top-up. Click on Pay Template. And just as before, we can add earnings line. Select the JobKeeper payment top-up that we added earlier and click OK. Here we may leave this value blank and complete this when we do each pay run, or if this is a part-time employee who may have regular hours, we can enter the amount now. Again, we calculate $540. We click Save. And we've updated this pay template. Now we will need to repeat this for each employee who is part-time, and perhaps even the casuals who may have varying hours. We can add that item, but with a $0 amount. If we now go back to the pay employee section, reset the entire pay run, our edits have disappeared, however, the earnings still show the 1,500 as required, and we can go in and check this. That, at this stage, is how Xero are recommending to process JobKeeper payments. Stay tuned, subscribe, hit the bell for future videos and updates on what to do once these new features are rolled out, and how to change this allowance item to comply and report back to the ATO through single touch payroll in Xero. Thanks for watching.